All right, good morning, August 17th, 2024, 0832 hours, otherwise known as 832 a.m. Station House. Your Saturday station agent, Will, and I'm trying something different today. I don't know if it's going to work out. I got a two-camera operation. I want to get started with a very luxurious morning shift kicker. Obviously, I've already been here about 2.5 hours, and I've done all the busy work that I need to do. But on KUSC this week, I discovered an artist named Roxane Elfasci. I believe I'm pronouncing that correctly, and I apologize if I'm not. Roxane Elfasci. She's a guitarist. Has to be of international renown, and me not know about her. That's just par for the course. There are artists out there known the world over that I've never heard of until accidentally discovering them. And in this case, it was on KUSC. I think it was while I was driving to work this morning. Not this morning. Driving to work in the morning one day this week. And on came this guitar rendition of Claude Debussy's Clair de Lune, which is just one of my all-time favorite compositions, just to begin with. But it was so, you know, in my history, there have been like less than a handful of times when music has stopped me in my tracks. And this is a case where it did. And so I want to play it for you just to get the morning shift kicker out of the way. Then, if the cameras are still functioning and I don't get swamped with passengers, I want to tell you a story so I can tell you a story. So let me get it rolling. Roxane Elfasci, from her 2021 album Hommage à Debussy, Suite Bergamasque, Clair de Lune. Thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed that. I kept some passengers on the lower car waiting while that finished, so let's get them up here. Just incredible. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Didn't keep you waiting too long. Good morning, thank you for riding Historic Angels Light. Please do remain seated until your car comes to a full and complete stop at the top. Anyway, Roxane Elfasci, Claire de Lune, absolutely magnificent. It's been out for 3 years. I'm just hearing it today, this week. I wanted to share it with you. It's the antithesis of the usual morning shit kicker, right? Usually my morning shit kicker is I call it the shift kicker, but that's what it is a shit kicker. Gets the blood pumping, but that gets the blood pumping in a whole different way. I get emotional at beautiful music, and that triggers. I hate that rule. It's not my rule. It's Metro's stupid rule. You should be able to tap for everybody.
I'm tapping for the whole car today.
Why not? All right, you're all set. Do you have a tap card?
No, and it was just one ride. Oh, no, it's $1.
So it's 50 cents for you and one for her.
Okay, so I tapped.
Yeah, you tapped. We're good to go.
Okay, have a good one.
You too. Thank you. Thank you. So it should be, it should be relatively manageable in terms of passengers the next period. Teared up a little bit there over Claire de Lune by Roxane Elfasci. Sue me. But I did have some schmutz I needed to wipe up over here. And we're good. I'm gonna blow my nose. Oh, yeah, just as I speak that, another passenger climbed aboard. Excuse me. I know you were living for that sound. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Good morning, thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated, no moving about the cabin while the cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the top. This is more Roxane Elfasci, by the way. This is the album Hommage à Debussy with my shitty French accent. I'm well, thank you.
Thank you.
Two for two, perfect.
Two, see ya.
What time do you open?
6:45, we run until 10 p.m.
Thank you.
Have a great day. People looky-looing down at the bottom. I don't know. Oh, I may try to... May try to float the drone for a three camera angle. There you go. If one turnstile is locked, try the other one. It's like mice in a maze. Yeah, we've been having problems with Olivet's bottom doors, arch side doors. They just take about 10, 20 seconds to open. All right. No one coming down. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Good morning and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while the cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the top. Float the drone right there and have like three, or maybe right there. Weird. Good morning, welcome.
Good morning.
Four for four, perfect.
There you go.
Excellent, thank you very much. Enjoy your day.
Thanks.
Take care.
Have a good day.
You too, thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today?
Good. Give us...
Thank you.
I can break that because they gave me four ones, but normally I would need exact change. Do you need round trips or what, just coming up?
Just coming up.
All right, it'll be $2. Two, three back, three change.
Give our knees some exercise.
Enjoy your day. Oh, Mormons. Good morning. Very good. Welcome aboard. Thank you. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated until your car comes to a full and complete stop at the bottom. The bottom doors have been opening very slowly this morning, so please give them about 20 seconds to do so. Thank you. No. Just took one from her. There's seven. Man, it's tough to keep track of the fares sometimes. Clear at the bottom, clear at the top. So I hinted about telling you a story to tell you a story, and I figured I'd give it a try. It's based on something I developed or played with this week. And the first part of the story is that it... the second part of the story is that you're often at the mercy of the chronically impatient passenger. So you're very limited as to what kind of information you can give over the intercom, right? Like you hear me, I'm very minimal, right? Thanks for riding. Please do remain seated, no standing. And like in this case, all of its bottom doors are slowed open, so I'll give a hand like, please, be patient. They will open, but don't force them. Be a good human. And, I've wanted to do more. I've wanted to add some factoids and tidbits, such as, thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight, widely considered to be not only the shortest railway in the world at 296 feet, but also the most traveled with an estimated 100 million and counting passengers who've sat where you're sitting. You'd think it would be no problem, but again, when you couple it with the fact that people, especially in the heat of the day, at the busy part of the day, with 20 people lined up at the bottom or up here to get on, that extra amount of time adds to it, right? And you wind up telling that story about however many times you send the cars. And that can get taxing too, so you kind of keep it brief for your own energy levels. and you keep it brief because you know your passengers, most of them don't care. Sad truth is they're riding it because it's something to do, or it's a thing they saw in a tourism book, you know, must do in LA. And God bless them, think, you know, I appreciate their patronage, but yeah, the vast majority of them just don't care about the fact that she's 122 years old and that she was built by a guy who was friends with President Lincoln and, you know, all that jazz. So in as a solution to that, rather than doing it on a trip-by-trip basis, hang on, it's either a ghost or a passenger. I started toying with the idea of making a YouTube video, you know, that you can either reference people to on social media, or people will just find when they search, you know, that's, you know, how to write the secrets of Angel's Flight, or how to write Angel's Flight, which not only incorporates etiquette and, you know, where to stand when you're boarding, fares, you know, all that jazz, but also includes historical points and points of interest relating to this historic landmark. Which is a great idea, and I could do it as Will, but when I started thinking about it, I started thinking about a past life when I was threatening to attempt to make acting a profession. And in that threat, I studied and studied acting. And like I said, it's a story within a story within a story, but the bottom line is I took a curriculum at the Stella Adler Conservatory of Acting West back in the 80s when I was in my 20s, before I met my first wife. Actually, before, during, and after I met my first wife. And, you know, ultimately, long sub-story short, in terms of an acting career, I didn't have the temperament for it. I didn't have the temperament for the bullshit. Something you should always consider with people who do make it in that business, the odds are incredibly rare, and the fortitude you have to deal with the rejection, to deal with the ass biters, and the parasites on the ass biters, it's superhuman, and that's my assessment of the industry. And to make it to any degree, and I've certainly had friends throughout my life who've made it to varying degrees, all I can do is applaud them, not only for their talent, but also for their ability to persevere through it, because I couldn't. And the story I'm going to tell you is one of the reasons why. And it will all come around, but if it doesn't, my apologies in advance. But in studying acting, and we're talking like beginning technique classes at the Stella Adler Conservatory, which used to be, it's on Hollywood Boulevard now, right near Highland, but originally it was at Hollywood Boulevard and Argyle, right near the Pantages Theater, in a great space. And back in the 80s, I studied with the likes of Benicio del Toro, Mark Ruffalo, and yeah, I'm not dropping names, I'm just saying that they were in my classes, and I got to know them to varying degrees. Mark Ruffalo was the most genuine, sincere, enthusiastic, wide-eyed young man you'd expect him to be. And Benicio del Toro was the cockiest, most arrogant you'd expect him to be. And look, and again, going back to my earlier point of what it takes to make it in this business, look at what those gentlemen have done, right? More power to them, and more power to them going forward too, because they're doing excellent work. If you watched me do these videos before, I don't post them that often, but my focus is down at the arch because passengers just tend to sneak on, and I want to make sure if they're on, they're moving. So fast forward. So I studied technique. I studied advanced technique, but in my beginning technique classes, I was with a teacher named Arthur. I'm not going to say his last name because the story doesn't paint him in the best light. But his name was Arthur, and he had fits of genius as a teacher. I'll relay one. Like I said, I go into tangents. I'll relay one exercise that I did for him. Oh, and speaking of the devil, they come out of the woodwork, literally. And they're just going to stand around, so we'll give them a minute. One of the exercises he had us do was a monologue. This is like 1986, 87, so forgive me if I don't know the play exactly or the characters. I don't know if I was Caesar or if I was Mark Antony. People just lingering out by the street, got people standing in the aisle, ignoring the no standing sign. So I'm going to wait until you get tired and sit down, sir. But it was a monologue dealing with the death of Pompey, who was Caesar's rival, and who Caesar defeated. Got to take a break while I deal with some passengers or wannabe passengers. Good morning.
$3.
Perfect. Welcome aboard. No time like the present.
Oh, wow.
Let me see if I give it a go, that little spiel I was telling you about, now that we got some passengers. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Good morning, thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight, widely considered to be not only the shortest railway in the world at 296 feet, but also the most traveled with an estimated 100 million and counting passengers who've sat right where you're sitting. Speaking of sitting, there is no standing while the cars are moving. Do please remain in your seats until your cars come to full and complete stops at the bottom of the top. Enjoy your flight. Hey, that went pretty well. If I do say so myself. Thank you. Welcome, welcome. Oh, tap cards galore. There's one, two, three, four, five. Bingo, thank you so much.
Good morning, Hugh.
Good morning. Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
Hi. Hello, hello, thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Full.
Credit card?
Credit card, yeah.
Okay. Do you need just one way or going back down later?
No, only one way. Only one way.
Well, that'd be $4.
Yes.
All right, $4 on your card. You're all set.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Oh, I'm gonna... Oh, they're getting off. Just taking their time getting off. Okay. So where was I? So the exercise that Arthur had me do, had the class do, was a monologue, I'm going to say from Julius Caesar, but it might be from another play, but anyway, and what how he had me do it was we had a student in the class, fellow student in the class, first name was George, relatively little guy, probably soaking wet, he wasn't over 110 pounds, and how he had me do the monologue, which I, of course, don't remember, was actually holding Pompey's, you know, holding George as Pompey. So I'm talking about Pompey and holding George. And like I said, even though he was about 100 pounds, as I'm going through this monologue, I'm having trouble holding him. And at one point, he's slipping out of my hands, and I had this thought of flinging him over my shoulder to continue the monologue, and I broke, and the thought of that made me chuckle, and I broke. Cardinal sin, and Arthur laid into me, and you know, I wound up, you know, putting George down, and he banished me to the back of the room, told me to think about the sin I committed in terms of breaking character, whether it's in a beginning technique class or on the stage at the Amundsen. It's something you just do not do. And I sat in the back of the class for the rest of the class, just stewing in my own juices over it. And I think Arthur saw that. And towards the end, he gave me another opportunity. He said, you want to try it again? And I'm like, phew. And I did. And this time, I did what I should have done in the first place. And because the monologue is about the anguish and the sadness, and you know, and it's about respecting the fallen Pompey, right? Your fallen foe, your vanquished enemy, and so I'm started up again, and I'm going through the monologue, and sure enough, George starts getting heavy again, and you know, I made that commitment to the character having difficulty letting go of Pompey in his mind. I physicalized that by trying my best not to drop him, not to lose him physically, right? Which is what the point of the exercise was, right? The truth of that moment, and I still get chills thinking about it because I went through the rest of the monologue and I'm struggling. I didn't fling him over my shoulder. That would have been a little too vaudevillian. But I, as he's falling, I go down on my knees and I lay him, you know, on the stage, and I'm continue the monologue to by the end where I'm emotionally, you know, just a wreck, and some of the audience too, and Arthur too, because I finished it, And he wasn't prone to praise, you know. He was very concise in his praise. But he just said, you know, that was perfect. Absolutely perfect. And, oh, and the sun's coming out. We had some nice cloud cover this morning, but the sun's burning that off finally. So I told you that story to represent, as kind of a fairness, to represent the genius that Arthur was. Because the rest of the story is about the asshole that he could be. And I went through the beginning scene, beginning technique, scene study, and it came about that Arthur was going to direct, I think the playwright's name is Langford. The play is titled Hot L Baltimore. It centers on a rundown hotel in Baltimore, thus Hot L, you know, the E and the sign is burned out. And the cast of characters that live in and visit and come and go throughout the play. And Arthur wasn't ready to commit to giving me a role for whatever reason. Maybe I wasn't talented enough overall. Maybe I hadn't proved myself well enough. But he did throw me a bone. Yep, we got passengers coming in. To be continued. Or not. I came over on this side. So he had me do the thankless job of stage managing. And I'll be honest, his stage management, what he wanted with this play, some of it was so inane. He had lighting cues that were really weird, you know, lights going down half, coming up three quarters. You know, meaningless shit that may have meant a lot to him, but was just ticky-tack busybody bullshit work. Sound cues, Janis Ian's 17 was a huge song throughout, and no, they're not writing. And on top of all the other things, stage managing is involved in terms of props and setting scenes and all that. And I agreed to do that. And the consolation prize he gave me was the role of the taxi driver who at the end of the third act comes in and his lines are literally, somebody order a taxi here, I ain't got all night. Now, that's fundamentally it. I may be ad-libbing a little bit, but it's a nothing part. You know, you can talk about there are no small parts, only small actors, but, you know, that was his reward to me for putting up with his bullshit as director in terms of stage managing this production. And it was a workshop production. It wasn't an elaborate set. It was on the stage that we'd studied at and were held classes at. So it wasn't a payment situation. I didn't make any money on it. But in the course of it, early on, and this is, we're talking like 1988, I'm at home. I'm still living at home at the time. People popping in. Are they going to ride? Right there. Are they going to ride? We'll see. Nope, not committing to it. We've got a monitor over there that I can kind of, the camera in the courtyard, I can see when people are coming in or turn around and go away. But this is a long, drawn-out story. I don't even know how long the cameras are going to last, so let me get back to it as best I can. But there was a day in 1988, I was still living at home with my mom. Actually, I wasn't. No, by 1980, let me correct. I had moved out on my own by 1986, but as it would happen, I was at my mom's house, my mom and stepdad's house, on the day my stepdad died. We were there, and she went in to give him a snack and found him dead in the bed. I think he was 88 years old, 87 or 88 years old, and it was the day of a performance. And call me selfish, but I called Arthur and said, hey, I can't come in today. My stepfather is dead. His body is in the bedroom. We're waiting for the police and the coroner. He died of congestive heart failure. Yet, like I said, he was 87 years old, functioning alcoholic. I think we got people coming back. Gotta make that step. Don't be afraid. Good morning, welcome.
Hi, good morning. Is it open now?
Absolutely. 6:45 in the morning till 10 at night.
Oh, okay.
7 days a week, 365 days a year. Do you need round trip tickets or just going down?
Round trip, please.
So for two, it'll be $4, please. Out of five. $1 back. Let me get your tickets to you. When you do come back up, you'll tear off those stubs on the end, drop them in the ticket drop. You can keep the center part as a souvenir.
Okay.
And we do run until 10 o'clock, so enjoy your day. No rush.
Thank you so much.
Welcome aboard. Can we get a picture of both of you?
Oh.
Why not? It's quiet. Not too busy. I'll do a vertical and a horizontal.
Okay.
So on three, one, two, three. And then on three, one, two, three. Good to go. You're very welcome. Enjoy your day. Good morning.
Good morning.
Tap card?
Tap card.
Awesome. Right here. Good to go. Double tap. Excellent. Try again. Well, it's seeing the tap card, but it's not registering it. You got to make sure, follow all the instructions. It's your phone, not mine. I can't tell you how your phone works.
Okay, so I have the tap card, but nope. I can't, since it's not working, could I get it discounted with my credit card?
We can't do anything under it. You do get a discount, uh-huh. But it would have to be cash. We can't do a credit card for anything under a dollar. So let's try your tap card one
can
more time.
Do a dollar and get it up and down, down and up?
No, the tap is one way only.
Okay.
Are you guys coming up? You're coming up later?
Yeah.
Coming later.
Let's just try it one more time. So it shows value. So
it shows value.
Hold near reader.
I mean, it always had this problem anyway. So we had to always go back.
So here's what I say. So you tapped already, right?
Yes.
So you'll tap again, and then it would when you guys come back up, it'll just be a dollar. So I'll give you this ride for free, and then you'll just owe me for both rides when you come back.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the bottom of the top. Just a note for people going down the hill, those doors at the bottom have been slow to open. Sometimes it takes up to 20 seconds, so please just be patient. Above all, do not try to force the doors open. Thank you. So I called Arthur and I said, my stepfather's dead, I can't make tonight's performance. And I don't want to put too fine a point on it, but anyone who's not a selfish asshole would probably say, is that too fine a point? Sorry. Like I said, first names only, not wanting to impugn who he is. Not that I don't even know where he is anymore, but point being, anyone who's not a total proud asshole would say, hey, I'm sorry to hear that, absolutely. Keep me posted. More later. Got passengers. Got cars coming up. Good morning, welcome.
One second.
Sure. Do you need round trip tickets or just coming up the hill?
Round trip, please.
For two, it'll be $4, please.
Can I take cash?
Cash or we do Apple Pay. You want to do Apple Pay?
Yeah, I do Apple Pay.
All right. Keeping it simple. And there's no extra surcharges. It's just straight four. Yes. Get your tickets to you.
Yeah, it's over there. Yeah.
I'll take these stubs for your trip up. When you're ready to go back down, tear off those stubs, drop them right in there, keep the center part. We run until 10 o'clock tonight.
Yeah.
Enjoy your day. All right, doors open, passengers coming on. Arthur did not do that. Arthur's went the exact opposite. How dare you leave me in the lurch like that? You know how important this is to me. Blah, blah, blah. You know, you better damn well be there. And I was just in shock. I had to like do a double take. Like, am I hearing this? Am I seriously hearing this? Like, my mother is a wreck. My stepfather, no love lost about my stepfather. Let's get that out of the way. But he was dead in the bedroom. And yeah, I'm gonna drop everything and come be a stage manager, fully focused stage manager, and a bullshit taxi driver at a certain point in Act Three. But Arthur just kept on. He says, I can't believe this, you know, the how, blah, 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 blah. And I went from being in shock to being enraged. And I'm typically an emotional guy, right? Like, so I don't handle three strollers? Three strollers and a scooter? The fuck? Here we go. Well, maybe I'll let them get settled and then I'll tell them to move their shit out of the aisle. Board, doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times until your cars come to full and complete stops at the bottom of the top. No standing. Thank you. kept it pretty cool in terms of controlling my outrage and just quitting right on the spot, because all I pictured was the joy of putting my fist directly into Arthur's head. Sure.
Yeah.
How many total?
So two kids and two adults.
Any of the children three and under?
Yes, one is two.
So no charge for her, so it'll just be, do you need round trip tickets or one way?
One way.
Just one way, yeah.
It would be $3.
Super.
All set?
Thank you.
Have a great day. Thank you very much.
Yeah. One second, guys.
Oh, I hope it fits. It's a tight fit through there. Good. Good morning.
Is it possible to walk down?
Sure, there are stairs.
Oh, okay.
These are directions to the stairs.
Okay, cool.
So just $1 coming up?
Yeah.
You're all set? Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm well, thank you.
Two
round trip?
Round, yeah.
So it'll be $4. $1 back. Let me get your tickets to you. When you're ready to go back down, just tear those stubs off the end, drop them right in there, keep the center as a souvenir.
Thank you.
We run until 10 o'clock tonight.
Hi.
Good morning.
We get the
round trip?
Yeah.
Round trip, yeah.
Sure. For two? Or how many?
Four.
Very good. You want to do like Apple Pay?
Yes.
You got it. Let me set that up. All right, four round trips is $8. Want to take a guess? Take a guess at the question?
I'd only come close. Let's say 150?
Close. Not. I'm looking for a little closer, but that's pretty close.
All right.
So when you guys are ready to go back down, you'll tear off those stubs on the end of those tickets, drop them right in there, keep the center part as a souvenir, and we run until 10 o'clock tonight, so you can guess again.
All right.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi there. For two?
Yes.
One way or round trip?
Round trip.
Very good. That'll be $4. All right, $4 on your card. These will be your tickets. When you're ready to go back down, tear off those stubs on the end, drop them right in there.
Okay, appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good day. More passengers already. All right. I may not even get to finish this story, so we'll see. Might have to cliffhang it. Because, I still got battery there. I don't know if I got battery there. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your car is moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the top. So, being surprisingly cool and calm, I just said, "All right, Arthur, I'll be there." Because, like I said, I had the motivation of being there just to punch him and then leaving. Or being arrested, depending on what he decided to do in the aftermath. If he could do anything. Now, I can't remember specifically if I called Victoria Kimsley, who was the assistant director and also a student of Arthur's, or if she heard from him and called me. But one way or the other, she called me up and acted the way you should, with empathy and kindness, and said how sorry she was, and that under no circumstances should I come to the theater that night. And I said, oh no, I'm coming to the theater. And hang on. Good morning.
Hi.
Welcome, welcome.
I have tap.
A Metro tap card?
Yep. Sorry, I'll...
Yeah, make it active, and if it has to be face recognized, that's what we're looking for. Yes.
Or two, sorry.
You can't tap twice.
Oh.
Tap card one time, okay. Per card.
Oh. Then I can pay $1.
Do you have a tap card by any chance?
No.
So it's $1.
$5.
Ooh, I'm hurting for change. We do take credit card if you don't
oh,
have...
Oh, yes. Great. Perfect. Wasn't sure. Perfect.
Set that up. Uh-oh. Hang on one moment.
It's my only cash that I have. $5.
Cash. Do you need a round trip or just coming up?
One way.
One way, good. Would be $1. All right, $1, you're all set. Enjoy your day. Good morning.
Good morning. Two, round trip.
Very good, it'll be $4. Let me get your tickets to you. Hang on one sec.
Yay, souvenir.
I'll take these stubs for your trip up. When you're ready to go back down, tear off those stubs, drop them right in there, keep the center part as a souvenir. We run until 10 o'clock tonight.
Thank you. Thank you.
Enjoy your day.
You too.
Thank you. All right, welcome back.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day. And Victoria did her best to dissuade me, but there was nothing going to keep me from that theater. So I loaded up and I got to that theater. And whether Arthur was inside and afraid to come out or whether he hadn't arrived, I just stalked the front door of that theater like a fucking beast. All I saw was red. And whether it was an overreaction or what, when you're treated that way, when you're treated that way, when you are exposed to that kind of selfishness, narcissism, I'm gonna deal with it. Hang on. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angel's Light. Please do remain seated until your cars come to a full and complete stops at the top. So I can't remember how long I was there, maybe about a half hour. It was a couple hours before showtime. It wasn't like, you know, everything was pretty quiet at the theater. And finally Victoria shows up. And again, she's like, hey, Arthur's inside and I told him that you're gonna kill him. So you're either gonna have to break the door down to get to him or you're gonna go home because he's not coming out and you're not going in. And more passengers.
Oh.
Good morning, welcome.
We owe you some money.
You do?
Yes.
How many? Is it two or?
Two. Two, yeah.
Do you need round trip or one way?
Just one way.
Be $2, please.
Music coming.
Oh, it's my speaker. There's a little hole. Oh, I'm sorry about that. Yeah, it's coming right. And I almost knocked over your drink. There we go.
That's okay.
So we're doing two, just yes, two.
Yes. Oh, no. Thank you.
Very good.
Thank you. I just was freaking out about where the music was coming from.
Like, all right, $2 on your card. You're all set.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day. Thank you.
Yeah, you too.
Glad I didn't knock your drink over.
What's that?
Glad I didn't knock your drink over.
Me too. Thank
you. All right.
Thank you.
For two? Thank you, sir. Hello, good morning. For two?
Yes.
Do you need up and down or just coming up? Just coming up?
Yes, just coming up.
Be $2. Okay, one, two. All right, you're all set.
Thank you.
Welcome, enjoy.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good, how are you doing? Tap card?
I do have a tap card.
Hang it up there. We're good to go.
Okay, thank you.
Enjoy your day.
All right, you too.
Thank you. Already at 9:30. Yeah, it's going to start just keeping going now. 2 fives. Good, good, good. So at some point, this battery's going to crap out. But we'll see. We'll keep it going as long as we can. Hey, a lull, so I can get a little more in. Not a lull. So I skulked around for a little bit longer and you know, Arthur wouldn't even come out and apologize. I think whether he was too chicken shit that it wouldn't matter and I would just slug him in the forehead or not, he wouldn't even give me the dignity of an apology at that moment. So I went home. And still stewing. There's a great skit by Bill Cosby. Sorry to reference Bill Cosby, but I was weaned on the Best of Bill Cosby album as a child. There's a great skit he did about revenge, about waiting an inordinate amount of time to get revenge on a neighborhood punk and finally getting it. Well, I didn't have to wait a long time. I decided the best course of action was to pretend like it was all just an unfortunate situation and to show up the next weekend, because the show only ran like, I think Thursday, it ran a couple days a week. So we had a week to quote unquote cool down, right? So whenever my stepfather died, was probably the last show that week. It was probably on a Saturday. I can't say for sure. But I had a whole week to quote-unquote cool down, and I showed up the next performance ahead of time. Got to work, getting the sets set. Getting the props placed, getting the lighting cues and the sound cues ready, and but I had a plan. I had a plan. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Good morning. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while the cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the bottom of the top. And I think when I finally did see Arthur that next day, or that next performance, he gave some half-assed, non-apology, you know, framed it under the, wow, we're all under such enormous amounts of strain, when we overreact, you know, all third-person shit. So, you know. Still not enough, because I think even at that point, if he had apologized, that might have been okay, that might have tamped my enthusiasm to get revenge, but he didn't, so it was on. Good morning, welcome. Hello.
What, three?
Three? Do you need round trip or one way?
Round trip.
Up and down? Very good. For three, it'll be $6. All right, $6 on your card. When you are ready to go back down, you'll tear off the stubs on the end there, drop them in the ticket drop, keep the center as a souvenir. We run until 10 o'clock tonight. Good morning.
Two. Good morning.
Two?
Yes.
Please. Round trip or one way?
Let's make a round trip then.
Round trip, very good. $4. $1 back. Let me get your tickets to you. Take this stub for your trip up. When you're ready to go back down, tear off those stubs, drop them right in there, keep the center as a souvenir.
Okay.
We run until 10 o'clock tonight, so no rush.
Hey, how's it going? Can I get two returns, please?
Two round trips, sure.
Two round trips.
$4. You want to do Apple Pay?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Very good. Let me get your tickets to you.
Thank you.
Sure. I'll take these stubs for your trip down. When you come back up, tear off those stubs, drop them right in there, keep the center part as a souvenir.
Thank you so much.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Enjoy your day. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight, widely considered to be the shortest railway in the world at 296 feet, as well as the most traveled, with more than 100 million passengers in its 122 years. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the bottom of the top. Enjoy your flight. That was pretty good. See, that's pretty good. Most people don't give a shit, but that was pretty good. $2 back.
Can I get a picture?
Sure.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Great. Thanks.
Enjoy your day. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hello.
Hello.
For two?
Yep.
Do you need round trip or just one way? Oh, you have tap cards? Tap right here. Perfect. One. 50 cents each. You're good to go.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Have a good day. Good morning.
Good morning.
Tap card. Excellent. Right here.
No roll?
Oh, it's got no balance. Do you have a tap card too? So, yes. So it's 50 cents each.
50.
So $1 is good for both.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sure.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. I can help you now if you're ready to go down. Perfect. Welcome back aboard.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. What am I doing with my binoculars? Move them over here. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Doors are closing. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the bottom of the top. A note to riders going down the hill, the bottom doors are sometimes a little slow in opening. They can take upwards of 10 seconds. Please do be patient. Above all, do not try to force the doors open. Thank you. Starting to warm up. Nice and cool here in the station house, but it is starting to warm up. So where was I? So I tried to go to the theater to kick Arthur's ass. I was dissuaded from committing that felony. And then I decided revenge would be sweet if delivered in an unexpected way. I showed up for the next performance about a week later, pretended like nothing happened. You know, Arthur made some half-assed non-apology, and I said, think nothing of it, Arthur. Think nothing of it. Good morning, welcome. How many tickets do you need?
Two.
Two?
Can I tap?
Like with Apple Pay?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you need round trip or one way?
Round trip.
Round trip for two?
Yeah.
It'd be $4. Let me get your tickets to you. When you are ready to go back down, you'll just tear off those stubs on the end, drop them right in there, keep the center as a souvenir. Okay. We run until 10 o'clock tonight. You can exit to your right, though. Hey, good morning.
Hello.
Two for two?
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, bye.
Enjoy your day. Lol? Nope. Anyone else? See, people want meandering. All right, let's let them meander in. So I went about my tasks as stage manager. I got everything, got the stage set, got all the props in place, you know, got all the lighting and sound cues, stupid as they were, reviewed those, had those ready to roll. Yeah, we're gonna close. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while the cars are in motion. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the top. Almost 10 o'clock. Halfway through. And I performed flawlessly as the stage manager through acts 1, 2, and 3, and then my time came to be the taxi, the cab driver. And as I said 400 hours ago, my lines consisted of entering through the main hotel door, saying, "Who here ordered a cab?" And then a few beats later, say, "Hurry it up, I don't got all night." Something to that effect. And that whole part of remaining seated until the cars come to a full and complete stop, still in effect. Thank you. There we go. Welcome, welcome. Tap card. Excellent. One for one. Two for two. Thank you. Good morning.
Hi.
For two?
Yeah.
$2, please. Perfect. Thank you. I can help you now. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Sure. Good morning.
Tap.
Metro?
Yep.
Yes.
Good to
Thank
go.
You.
Welcome aboard. Morning.
We're going down again. We have to pay again?
Yeah, $1 up, $1 down.
Okay. Yeah.
That quick?
Yeah.
Boomerang. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. Good morning and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. So I have two throwaway lines. Who here ordered a cab? Boom, 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 boom. Hurry up, I ain't got all night. My revenge was, I chewed up that scene like I was the star of the play. I came on with a thump instead of just walking in the door. And I proceeded to turn two lines into like 20 with a lot of expletives. Try to give you a paraphrased example after I get these passengers up. Please stay seated until the car comes to a stop. Thank you. She's 122 years old. You can wait 10 more seconds. Excellent. Now you're good to go. The last thing you want is for her to... and then you wind up dropping everything. Do you need round trips or just going coming up?
Just coming up. Coming up.
It'll be $2, but I can't break a 20.
Oh.
We do take credit card, debit card, Apple Pay, Google Pay. Very good. $2. You good to go?
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you.
You too.
Thank you. So to paraphrase, I come on loudly with the equivalent of "Who the fuck ordered a cat?" And I totally just blew out the accent instead of just saying the lines. I totally went East Coast belligerent with "Who the fuck here ordered a cab, leaving me waiting outside 10 minutes? Are you deaf? Do you not hear the fucking horn? I'm freezing my balls off out there. You got 5 seconds." And whatever little audience there was, every actor on the stage could have heard a pin drop. And I wait a beat, and I'm like, "You think I'm fucking joking? You got no time left. If you want, I'm leaving right the fuck now. You know how cold it is out there? I've been waiting here." And I just went over the lines again, hitting the horn like I'm being murdered. And what? No one comes out? I'm not a moving company. You got baggage? Carry it yourself. I'll be out in the car. And then I leave. And as I'm leaving, Arthur's backstage, and he had a look on his face that was very interesting. He, half enraged, because he was not one for improv. Half just wide-eyed, livid. And I looked right at him as I walked. I didn't cower away from him. If he'd said anything, I would have walked up and punched him. But then he had a look. There's a guy in here.
There's a guy? Is there a guy?
How are you guys doing?
Guy with a cool hat.
Doing well.
You got the, what is it?
Two going down?
Yes.
Yeah. You're all set? Welcome aboard.
Thank
you. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Good morning, and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times until your cars come to phone complete stops at the bottom of the top. So sorry, I got conflicting shit. I got home shit, I got work shit, and I got the shit that's going on in my mind that I'm trying to communicate to you. So anyway, so I come off stage after that stellar performance of overacting, and I'm looking at Arthur, and like I said, if he had done anything, if he had so much as looked at me the wrong way, and he looked at me half the wrong way, the other half was kind of like, my interpretation of it was, I guess I had that coming, right? It was kind of like, almost like a begrudging appreciation for the way I decided to, quote unquote, get back at him. Good morning, welcome. How are you today?
Good, thank you.
How many tickets do you need?
Three.
Round trip or one way?
Round trip.
It would be $6 together or $2 each?
I have six.
I'm hurting for change though, if you have two ones. Oh, you're going to do all six?
Yep.
Excellent. Let me get your tickets to you.
You don't have to go down right away, right?
No. Negative. We're open till 10 o'clock tonight. So take all your time. But let me explain what you need to do with your tickets. Okay. When you are ready to go back down, there's the stubs on the end. You'll tear those off, drop those right in there. You can keep the center part as a souvenir.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Enjoy your day.
So
we'll see you on the other end.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Just one ticket.
One way, $1.
Yep.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you. Enjoy your day. Enjoy those donuts. Hi there.
Can we pay with tapping?
Like an Apple Pay?
Yeah.
Yes. Do you need round trip or one way?
Round trip.
Gotcha. That'd be $4. Just set it up. Let me get your tickets. When you're ready to go back down, you'll tear up those stubs on the end, drop them right in there, keep the center part as a souvenir.
Okay,
we run until 10 o'clock tonight, so enjoy your day. Thank you. Good morning.
Hello, I have tap.
Excellent. Perfect.
Thank you.
Welcome to board. Yeah, it's already warming up out there. I mean, it's not even, it's barely 10. It was already warm. Welcome aboard, doors are closing. And that pretty much saved him. So that look that I, whether it was my own subjectivity or not, I saw what I needed to see, that he was acknowledging that I got him back in a way that was unexpected, and appreciated. Because he kind of had this kind of weird, you know, crazy-eyed, weird smile face. Please be advised, the doors at the bottom are a little slow in opening. They typically take about 10 seconds to do, so just be patient. Oh, there they go. Great. Enjoy your day. And I walked right past him and went back to the stage managing booth where, you know. Here's the ultimate irony. Is that the night I did that, was the night that a reviewer from Dramalog magazine was in the audience. And a week later, the review came out and pretty much savaged the production, rightfully so. It wasn't very good. But at the end of it, I went by my middle name back then. I didn't go by Will until the 90s, early 90s. But right at the end of it said, Doug Campbell is the cab driver, made the most of his brief time on the stage. And positive review, right? my one review. In the history of my, brief career as an actor, and I get a positive note in writing. I've still got the review somewhere. I'll have to dig it up. I don't know where it is. So that's the ultimate irony, is that my revenge paid off with pretty much the only positive thing said about the entire play and everyone in it. Now, that was a story within a story within a story to tell you another story. Because going back to my desire to provide historical context to Angel's Light, to Passengers, and you've heard me do it a couple times throughout the course of this deathless monologue. Good. I thought about that whole thing and kind of the character I developed for that cab driver, and with that accent, with that kind of East Coast belligerence, you know, no bullshit. And I started kind of just, passengers coming. Good morning.
Good morning. Oh, hello.
Hi. You need two tickets?
Yes. We actually have tap cards.
Yes. Excellent. Yes. Even better. Just hold them up here. And it's 50 cents.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Welcome to board.
Yes.
You're all set. Woo. Enjoy. But I may have to save that story. I mean, I don't know. We're kind of at the tail end. You're long done. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for writing historical Angel's Flight, widely considered not only the shortest railway in the world at 296 feet, but also the most traveled, with an estimated 100 million passengers in its 122 years. Please do remain seated at all times until your cars come to full and complete stops at the bottom or the top. Enjoy your flight. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. So if I get you to read that sign, you're not supposed to stand there, and it says so. Appreciate it. Good morning, welcome.
Good morning.
How many tickets?
Yeah, three.
Three for three? Perfect, thank you, sir.
Go. We'll come back later.
Hi there, one for one, thank you. Two for two, thank you. Three for three, thank you. And four for four, thank you. Good morning.
Hi.
How many tickets do you need?
Three.
Three, round trip or one way?
Just one way.
Be $3, please. Very good. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day. Good morning. Credit card? Oh, tap card. Sometimes these don't work on this machine, so we'll call it even.
No?
Yeah, it won't. Let me try one more time. Oh, yeah, it won't work. So we'll call it good. It's not you, it's the machine. So I'm giving you a free ride. Or not. I'm saying you can go. Sir, you can go. It's our machine that's the problem, not your card. So you no charge. Have a good day. For how many? For four? Perfect. Thank you much. Welcome. I can help you with the tickets now.
Hi, do you have a change?
I do. I can do change. Do you need round trip tickets or one way?
Round trip.
Coming back up later?
Yes.
So it'll be for two, it'll be $4.
Okay.
Change. $1 change, let me get you your tickets. I'll take these stubs for your trip down. When you come back up, you'll tear off those stubs on the end, drop them right in there, keep the center part as a souvenir. We run until 10 o'clock tonight, so no rush.
Mm.
Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hello.
Hey, so we put the little ones in here?
You got it.
Okay, perfect.
Perfect.
They're watching you in England.
Oh, really?
Yeah, hey. I said, I just told them they're watching you in England.
Yeah. Oh, you're doing...
They're
hi.
England.
Hello, hello.
Oh, she's asking, how are you?
I'm doing very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
Excellent. Good to talk with you. Enjoy your day. That's very cool. Just talking with someone with England. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Good morning and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the bottom of the top. Enjoy your flight. Tickets?
Six.
Do you need one way or round trip?
One way.
Very good. It'll be $6.
Can I pay by card?
Sure. All set?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Enjoy your day. Thank you. Still rolling. So, no lull, got passengers. So the bottom line is I started doing a alter ego station house agent with kind of the, like the East Coast belligerent, but not rude. I mean, you know, East Coast belligerent, explaining the rules of the rails of Angel's Flight and the historical context of Angel's Flight. And so I'm thinking about, you know, doing that into a YouTube video in the station house, you know, welcome to Angel's Flight, sit the down, you know, okay. And I did a couple rough recordings of it. I haven't listened back to them yet, but we'll see. We'll see if it turns into something. But all that story was for that little end, is that, you know, good morning.
Hi.
Do you need a round trip or one way? Oh, tap card?
Yeah.
It may not work on this machine. Let's give it a try. Yeah. So it's 50 cents. You still get the discount for having the tap card, but it'll be 50 cents.
I want a downward, one single trip downward.
Right, 50 cents. Very good. Get your, do you have anything smaller than a 20? I can't break a 20.
I only have this one.
Let's see what that says? One. Two, three, four, five, six, eight, nine, 10, 11, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, and 19. Just destroyed my ones. $19.50.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard. You're free to board. Thank you. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Good morning and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to full and complete stops at the bottom of the top. I'm liking this music, but so without actually going into it, the East Coast belligerent thing, I'm gonna kind of end it there, and we'll just record the rest of my shift as the battery sees fit, and we'll see what happens. Certainly, if a YouTube video ever results, I will link to it, and you'll be able to enjoy it or not. Gentlemen in the lower car, you were directed to remain seated until the cars stop moving. It's really a simple rule. Appreciate you following it. Thank you. Good morning. Welcome.
Good morning. Do we pay here?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you need a round trip ticket or one way?
Round trip, please.
And you want to do like Apple Pay or?
Can I do my tap card?
Well, you can tap for one way.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Right here?
Okay.
So it'll be 50 cents now, and then when you want to go back down, you'll tap again
okay.
for another.
I can kind of like wander around up here.
Oh, yeah. We run until 10 o'clock tonight. So
okay.
Take your time. Enjoy.
Hello.
Hi. It was fun.
Oh, glad you enjoyed it.
Little short ride.
It's the shortest railway in the world.
Oh.
296 feet.
最短的铁路. Oh. So here's us.
Oh, I love quarters.
I knew it.
Awesome. Is that $3? Yes, it is.
Uh-huh.
You're all set. Thank you very much. Good morning. Well, you have to pay. It's up and down. Where's your tickets?
Oh, you didn't give me?
I gave you tickets. If you bought round trip tickets, I gave you 4 tickets.
Oh. What did I pay?
I gave you these.
I didn't receive any.
Huh? I didn't get any.
Then you didn't pay for round trip.
Oh, I paid though. But the man was here, and we just went out.
You lost?
Well, you paid one-way tickets.
I paid $8, anyways.
But I would have given you tickets if you paid for round trip. Did you pay with credit card or with cash?
With cash, $8. But it's okay, we'll pay again.
Because you were taking pictures, I remember that.
Yes. Who?
But someone else paid, right? Did you pay?
I paid $8.
Oh, you don't
pay. I said four.
One way.
No, that's $4. I mean, that's $8.
Well, I don't want to overcharge you, but if you had asked for round trip tickets, I would have given you tickets. And if you're saying you didn't get tickets, then that's
okay. We'll just pay again.
I'll call it even. No, I don't want to take your money if you say you paid $8 and I didn't give you tickets. Welcome aboard.
Thank you. Really good day.
I don't doubt it. That's weird. Hate that shit. Hello. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of your day. It's great. I paid $8. You didn't pay $8. If you paid $8, I would have given you tickets. Welcome back.
You got all 3 of ours?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
Some sunflower seeds. Man, I don't have a cup. I don't have a little boat. I have anything? Oh, there's a bowl. Excellent. Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Please do remain seated at all times while your cars are moving. No standing until you come to a full and complete, absolute and total stop at the top or the bottom. Switch up the music. Ah. Welcome. Welcome back. Right in there, you're good to go. Good morning.
Tap?
Metro?
Yes.
Metro tap card? Yeah, hang it up there.
I don't have sorry, I thought it was like...
Oh, it's a credit card?
Yeah, that's okay.
Are you paying just for yourself or?
Two of us, please.
Do you need round trips or one way?
Just one way, please.
Be $2.
Thank you.
Good to go.
Thanks.
Enjoy your day. Thank you. Welcome, welcome.
Hey, welcome.
How many tickets?
We have five and three pays.
Yeah, anyone over three pays.
All right.
Do you need round trips or just coming up?
No, just coming up.
For five, it'll be $5.
Oh, exactly.
Perfect. One, two, three, four, five, six.
Okay.
All set. Thank you.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day.
Thank you.
Take care. Good morning. Good morning.
Hi.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Little part right in there.
Yep.
Careful.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, I don't know what's going on with my hands.
Hi there.
Morning, I'm two people.
Two? Do you need a round trip or just coming up?
Oh, yes, round trip.
Round trip? It'll be $4. $1 change. Let me get your tickets to you. When you're ready to go back down, you'll just tear off those stubs on the end, drop them right in there, keep the center as a souvenir.
Got it.
And we run until 10 o'clock tonight, so no rush.
Great.
Enjoy your day. Thank you. Oh shit.
Ride.
Welcome aboard. Doors are closing. Good morning, and thank you for riding Historic Angels Flight. Widely considered not only the shortest railway in the world at 296 feet, but also the most traveled, with an estimated 100 million and counting passengers sitting right where you were over its 122 years. Speaking of seats, please do remain in them throughout the course of your journey. No standing until you come to a full and complete stop at the top. Enjoy your flight. Sir, back up. Back up. Passengers coming off. Go back up.
Woof. I'm going to pay for everyone, all six.
All six? Awesome. Good to go. He got you. You're covered.
Thank you, guys.
Enjoy your day.
Can you guys give a card by any chance over here?
I'm sorry?
Can you pay a credit card over here?
Sure. Okay. Apple Pay, Google Wallet, credit card, debit card. You got it. Now we're good. It didn't work going up. It's not going to work going down. Welcome aboard.
Huh?
Welcome aboard. Your card is no good here.
I can pay for them. I can have them.
Okay. It's 50 cents. He has a tap card, but it doesn't work on our... He's going to pay for you.
I got it. Huh?
No. Yeah, you're good.
Please. Please. Thank you, thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. I can pay with card or I will have to pay you?
Oh, no, card is good.
That's good.
Okay. Do you need round trip or one way?
Yeah, round trip.
For two?
Yeah.
Be $4.
Okay.
Yep. Two round trip. All right, $4 on your card. These will be your tickets.
Thank you.
When you come back up, you'll tear off those stubs on the end, drop them right in there, keep the center as a souvenir. We run until 10 o'clock tonight.
Okay.
Tap card?
Yeah.
Good. And we're good. You can't re-tap.
Okay.
I appreciate it, though. Thank you.
For three people.
Sure.
Tap card?
Five people.
Oh, five people.
With, you can tap for one person. You can't tap for five.
Oh, okay.
So that's one.
Can you do them separately?
Do what?
No.
Yeah, the tap card, you're only allowed to tap for yourself.
Oh, okay.
So are there how many other passengers? Four?
Four.
And do you need round trips or one way?
One way.
So it'll be $4. You want to do with a credit card? Or you have a tap card?
No, but I haven't used it in a while. So I need to log in and stuff.
Well, you want to try? Do you all have tap cards or
no,
just?
No, they don't. It's just, no, let me just.
Well, no, so you, because you have the tap card, you get the discount.
Oh, okay.
So it's 50 cents.